Delphmocracy, it's been a bit of a struggle so far. We had a bit of a rough game. It's hard. I find it hard to play the Dark Elves early on, especially with an assassin. Like, having an assassin is just a complete liability. Two journeymen.
Are you ready to play? Good evening from Cabal Vision HD.
When you come back to Blood Bowl 2, can you start me occasionally because you've been a good boy lately?
What?
I don't know. I haven't decided. Depends how I feel at the time.
Exotic nations, Bob. Nice weather to play Blood Bowl.
I'm thirsty.
I have to leap once just to confuse the crap out of my opponent. Well, you mean so he spends the next 5 minutes sitting there thinking to himself, why is that idiot leaping? What was he thinking? Someday he will stab a roller to death. Is that the plan? One of these days he'll kill something.
Certainly excel in certain domains.
There we go. Let's have a look at his team.
Simply put,
he's got a fairly standard team with nothing special because our team is low level. So let's do what we can do then. As always, we're going to put the assassin on the line of scrimmage and try and stab the crocs. You thought, oh no, the assassin's missed next game, isn't he? We can't even try and stab the crocs. The good thing is, funnily enough, against lizards, we have a diving tackle runner and a diving tackle blitzer. What more could you want against lizard men? Like, why? It's almost like our team is built to counter lizards. Diving tackle everywhere, just what you need. He's going to let me punch some skinks right off the bat. Okay. Guys, is it worth trying to one dice surf a Saurus? I feel like it is, you know. I feel like if you're gonna play the game, you might as well play the game properly. And by properly, I mean you might as well try and do rando one dice surfs. Shame we couldn't get a guy in there, really. Okay, let's do this. Maybe some good old-fashioned kickoff return. It's worth one dicing both of them. You can do both of them? Could we, with the one dices? Maybe, I suppose. We could have done.
On balance, I prefer the passing to running down the field. One tactic is for the intellectual elite. The other is for simpletons.
I like running down the field.
What the hell is going on?
Whatever type I am.
Okay, it freaks me out when the game does this and just randomly goes around the other side. Right, well let's do the important part first, which is to punch some skinks.
They just got owned.
Damn it.
That's what the cool kids are saying, isn't it?
Jeremiah Cool always.
Oh, come on, game.
Superior skills prevail.
Okay. So we could Let's just do it. Let's just burn some rerolls.
That's it. Get in their face.
Oh, okay. there's a lot of things my team needs. I'm not sure if a nosedive is one of them. To be fair, actually, though, saying that, probably nosedive the War Dancer was probably one of the best performing players we've had on any of our teams. Nosedive the War Dancer scored a ton of touchdowns. So many he scored. So many touchdowns. My luck recently. Yeah, that was a good set of blocks. All two dice. It goes one or two ways. Like we tend to either have like rather than having like a good game, bad game. My luck seems to go like bunch of really good games, bunch of terrible games, bunch of really good games, bunch of terrible. Like rather than it being game by game, it's like day by day. Like I have a really good day where the whole day's good, and then I'll have a day where I just get pitch cleared by peasants and orcs kill me. It took him a while to get his head in the game. It did. It took him a while to get going. But when he... It took him a while, like 20 games to get going. But once he did, once he got a few levels, he actually turned into a complete monster. He scored so many touchdowns. And not only did he score a lot of touchdowns, he did a very good job at just crushing ball carriers all over the place. He actually did a bunch of ridiculous stuff, that guy. I was going to say, he has to follow up because...
Don't push him out of the way. Foul him off the pitch.
Okay, so that's three skink punches, which has got us nowhere.
That's a flurry of blows the opposing player is taking.
She just won't stop. I don't know whether to be excited or disgusted. Pushing. Ha!
on the edge of the field there, within grasping range of the fans. And they're looking hungry.
Oh. Have a lot of the teams retired? Not really, because we've mainly been playing the two democracy teams. So we haven't really retired a bunch of teams. Kind of want to... I mean, that's a risk, but... surely a risk that's worth taking. Oh, really, game? That's the one you're going to make me fail? Oh, well, now the 67 seems a lot less.
The players arrive to assist their teammate.
What's down to you? See what I mean? Skinks are invincible.
Get up or get off the field.
Skinks are invincible. The block with the rich elf afterwards. I wasn't really concerned with the block afterwards with the rich elf. I figured I'd just try and put him in a bad spot and then make him roll a bunch of dice again. I didn't think I'd get a chance to surf him that turn. But yeah, goddamn skinks are invincible. Oh wait, at least he bonehead, which is good.
I think he's moving. No, he's not.
Push is good for us though. That works. So all of these guys are done now. This guy can still come over and blitz and be annoying. Invincible skinks are what get me though.
And that's what he'd say if he could talk.
Yeah, it's pretty it's pretty brutal, just really. Like, that's like four, like he let me punch his skinks four times already by turn two. And we just haven't been able to do anything worthwhile with it. And now we're in a pretty crappy spot. I should make an all line rat team with players named Nosedives. Funny enough, Blood Bowl doesn't make me angry. Like, it's weird. Like, even in situations like this, it doesn't make me angry. It just makes... you know what? It's a weird feeling. Like, when I play... sometimes other games, when I play Street Fighter gets me really frustrated at times, and I get really like, oh, goddammit, game. But Blood Bowl, like, occasionally I get a bit like that, but more often than not, I just end up feeling disappointed that the game has let me down. I'm like... yeah. I feel like... I feel like a parent who's just realised their child has done something really horrible. It's like, you know, I'm past the point of being angry. I'm just disappointed. Like when a child draws on the curtains. Arctic Antarctic Winds. That's a cool name. Arctic Antarctic Winds. Thank you very much for the follow. I really, really appreciate it. I'm glad you're enjoying the stream. And I hope you enjoyed your little goblin dance. Thank you. Much obliged, good sir. Much obliged. Come on, die, skink, die. Oh, god damn it, you invincible skink git. Why do you hate me so? Right. And then Le Double Skull. Oh, skink. Oh, skinky skink McSkinks. I really needed that. Oh. Oh, that is glorious. Like thank you, game. That counts as a quick pass, doesn't it? Yeah. Although. Two 83s and then a pass, as opposed to just. Ah, sod it. You know what? Just throw the ball.
Here should do nicely.
It'll be alright. Yeah. Okay, that's kind of bad, because now the skin can get it, but either way. He woke you up from a nap after the ball bounced the wrong way. Nice. You just go there to watch the salt. Yeah, it's never been my way. I mean, you know, people know me. I do. This is not to say that I do not get angry at video games. I do get angry at video games, a lot of video games, but I'm not the whole, like, I'm never going to be screaming down the microphone and all that, because it's just, you know, not my thing. I prefer to just explain to you all how I feel like Satan has just rose up from hell to flick me in both of my testicles. Now I'm gonna loot. Probably. Lizards. I always struggle against lizards because I have this problem. People always say to, like, every time I play lizards on most teams, people say, "Oh, just punch the skinks." But I always have this same problem. I punch the skinks, and the skinks just laugh at me and go, "Haha, what are you playing at? We're just gonna bounce. We're just gonna bounce off the pitch constantly." They never actually die. Do I need a hero? Not even remotely, Nosedive. When did democracy become the... I don't know, but I mean, people... I'm not quite sure. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's not like I'm the first person to come up with this. It's just that... People had been mentioning it in stream for a while that, like, on virtually every team I played, people were always saying, "Oh, take this skill, take that skill, take this skill." And people had been mentioning it in for a while that it would be fun to have a team whereby they got to pick instead of me picking all the time. So eventually it just became, I just thought, you know, why not? Let's do it. Let's give people the opportunity to...
He won't leave him alone anytime soon.
to pick the skills. I've been saying for a while that I would do it when I got round to it. And I figured now was as good a time as any. I wanted to get through... the plan originally was that I wanted to get through most of... I wanted to at least play some normal games with most of the teams before I started. Once we'd had a go on all of the teams, then it became like, yeah, let's do it now. Just roll sixes. Just roll them sixes. And just roll them fives. That was a 5+ dodge. God damn you, game. Why do you despise me so?
That was very close.
But yeah, I do have this problem a lot against Lizardmen teams. Like, I do my best to punch the... to punch the skinks and such, it doesn't always work out because they just refuse to die. Please no. That's like six blocks on skinks. Successful blocks, mind, not just any old blocks. That's bad. Oof.
That player is bouncing up faster than an inflated squig.
Is that the way it works? To injure skinks, you have to get good. Yeah, I don't know. It's just one of those games. Like, honestly, this is the game you play where all the skinks are just made of rubber. You just punch them and they just bounce back up again. So what? It's not. I mean, to be fair, it's not like things are going completely horribly. Like, we've had one KO. It's not like we've all died or anything like that. It's just. It's one of those games where you know you could just feel yourself slowly losing.
Come on, guys, together.
Dun, dun, dun. You must. I cannot impress upon you all enough how much you are never going to see the Ogre Leap animation. I cannot impress upon you all enough how that's never gonna happen. It was nice of him to move his Crocs out of the way. I don't know why he did that. I would not have moved the Crocs away from that ball at all. But yeah, I'll have to thank him.
Move right next to a teammate.
What we really need now, because he's almost certainly going to try and dodge this guy away again. He must do. I feel like he's going to try and dodge this skink away. What we need is for him to fail the dodge from the diving tackle guy. What's the point of having diving tackle if you never diving tackle anyone, Black Fancy Pants? Hey?
For remaining upright. Pride comes before the fall.
Goddamn Black Fancy Pants. Go on, do it. Kick him. Kick him to the floor. See what I mean? Look, he's done it again.
Oh.
God damn it, game. You suck. Lembocha, I appreciate you being here, based on the fact that the peasants stamped all over my face. welcome. Oh, the peasants. You know what? If I could have got all the way to the touchline, I would have been tempted to run him first and then pick the ball up with this guy. Let's just do some things. I really want to... at this point, I just want to injure a skink. Yeah, it definitely was a... Yes, we got one! We got a KO! It was indeed incredible. It was Squirrel Dude, wasn't it? Wasn't that you, Squirrel Dude? I still... Honestly, I tried to blank it from my memory. So you wouldn't even be mad. Yeah, it was pretty hilarious. Honestly. What do we want to do? This guy's probably better. If we can get the ball on the Witch Elf, nice maybe. Room with a shout. How do we even lose to a... Yeah, check the YouTube channel, man. You will see. It just... The way you lose to all peasants is literally by... them just being spectacular. Like, I can't honestly can't describe it any other way. The peasants were just too good for them. That's all it is. They were just too damn good. They taught me the meaning of Christmas in the worst possible way. Yeah, stand up. It was just pretty horrific all round, to be honest. Limbocha, thank you very much for the follow, man. I really, really do appreciate it. I'm glad you're enjoying the stream, and I hope you enjoyed your little goblin dance. Thank you. Much obliged. I forgot one of my blitzers didn't do anything in the match, anything in the second half. Did I really forget a blitzer? I don't know. I honestly don't feel like I did anything that, like, there was nothing I could have done in that game that would have made a blind bit of difference. The peasants were just too good. Like, they were clearly the superior team. From turn one, they just punched me to the ground and stamped all over my face. But yeah, thanks, Lem. I really do appreciate it. Much obliged, good sir. Much obliged. It was even at the time, like, still, it's hilarious. Like, I still find it funny. To come out on top. It's just... Oh. But yeah, we had a pretty bad run of it. That whole God, poor old Grumpy. Oh, minus strength. You, sir, are almost certainly not long for this world. I always say that. It makes it seem like if they lose a point of strength, instead of letting them retire, I just take him out the back and shoot him. That's not true. Like, you are retired, Grumpy, is what I should say. You're not dead, you're just retired. I'm sorry, Grumpy. Is this the open qualifier? No, this is the normal league, the NAF, the open league. And this team and the human team that I was playing earlier are teams they're democracy teams. We let the chat pick the skills. So every time we get a level up, we do a little giveaway, and whoever wins gets to pick the skill. Which is kind of why we have Diving Tackle on our Blitzer. Because chat picked Diving Tackle on a Blitzer. It's like our human team's got, like, pro everywhere. Get one. Yes, we KO'd another one. Look at all the glorious KOs we're getting on these skinks. Sweet. Yeah, we have got some teams in the qualifier. I have played quite a few qualifying games on different teams. But for the purposes of doing the democracy teams, the World Cup qualifier just doesn't give me enough games to do it, because it's going to take me more than 20 games to get a bunch of levels on everyone. I mean, it's taken me nearly 20 games to try and get level 2 on the ogre, and he still hasn't managed it. So, you go there. God, we actually might get out of this 1-0 up, which would be pretty fun times. Le triple dice. Yeah, KOs are indeed not deaths. It's pretty unfortunate. Go on, get him. Get him. Oh. I'm disappointed, game. Do I want to take a one dice? Yeah, let's take a fruity one dice. He's about to get punched above and below the belt. At the same time.
He won't leave him alone anytime soon. That player is so close to
me. Okie dokie. Right, let's see what happens then. Whew, I think we might get away with this. We might get a 1-0 at half time, which would be good. But yeah, the Open League gives us the opportunity to play a ton of games so that we can actually get levels on everyone and give the people the skills that they want. Otherwise, we'd play 20 games and then be like, okay, we'll have to start again. No long term, though. That's okay. That is okay, Black. I wonder if he commits his blitz over here, or if he actually tries to put pressure on the ball. If he commits his blitz over here, Lembocha, I definitely agree with you. I definitely agree with you. I had a dwarf team, and our dwarf team had like two diving tackle pieces on it, and the amount of times we got turnovers using diving tackle, because people would make a dodge and not realise that I had diving tackle, was unbelievable. The fact that it doesn't actually tell you beforehand, that the game doesn't tell you that you're dodging away from diving tackle, is actually a massive bonus for the skill. The skill is 10 times better because the game doesn't tell you. It catches people off guard so much. Okay, so he's not, yeah, it's crazy the amount of times people get caught out by it. So what's he going to do with it? This is the important, he's actually going this way. This is good for me, because now I get a chance to, well, I say it's good for me, at least now I get a chance to surf this guy with a couple of one dice blocks again. Like, I'll take the opportunity to surf a Surfosaurus with some one dices. And it also means that I don't think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He can maybe get there. It's going to be hard work. Maybe two dice into one dice. So I feel like I'll just take the two. Oh no, maybe I'll do it this way. Yeah, I'll do it this way.
They're gathering around that lone player. Awesome. Like halflings round a sandwich.
But now at least this is two dice into two dice.
He's following up, hoping to get the knockdown next time.
There we go. Go on, kill the skin. Kill him.
He's got nothing.
No!
Hasn't she, Bob?
Damn you, game. Wife. Oh, Luskull. No. Does the floor actually say minus two? I've never even noticed that. I've never noticed that the floor says minus two. I really haven't. I think the problem with the game is that after you've been playing the game for a little while, the game does such a good job on like 90% of the skills of telling you the percentages of it happening. Like, if you spend all your time dodging and the dodge is like, it says 83%, so you dodge. Like,
oh dear. Expensive.
Oh, I tell you what, these Dark Elves have had a rough time of it. They've really had a rough time of it. We keep trying to get the team going, and they just keep getting butchered. Don't know what's the matter. The humans get all the good luck, and the Dark Elves get all the bad luck. Oh, the team got better. Yes, the team probably got better because we no longer have a runner with diving tackle. But yeah, no, I didn't. Back to the diving tackle thing. The game does such a good job at giving you the percentages for stuff. It's very, very strange, like, that the game would not give you the percentage when it knows you have to make a diving tackle dodge. Like, it knows in advance that you have to roll 5+. So why not just tell you that the roll is 5+? That means I have room for a nosedive. It does indeed mean I have room for a nosedive. Oh, see what I mean? God damn it. Poxy lizard men. I hate lizard men. I really do. No, I don't hate lizard men. I hate playing against them. They suck. You spend the whole game chasing skinks around trying to kill them, and they don't die. And then the Saurus and the Crocs eventually murder your team. Lizard men scum. That's just against me, though. The Saurus do indeed hit hard. Or a Brontosaurus came down from Slanhotep. And when the match was over, the Elfie was Zoic. You only hate them less than rats, but yeah. Yeah, I hate lizardmen more than I hate rats. But I honestly feel like that's just because I don't actually play against rats that often. Like, it's really weird. Like, the amount of Skaven teams I actually play against, they're very, very slim. Compared to the rest of the teams. I feel like we get way more lizards than we do Skaven. Like, we kind of, playing in the open league, we kind of get Chaos at high team value, and then we kind of get Orcs. We get Orcs and Lizards a lot, and then the rest of the teams are just kind of once in a while. Yeah, we are in, we are in a bit of a pickle, aren't we? Really. We are in a wee bit of a pickle. So dead, injured. Yuck. And we have managed to KO one skink. Give Nurgle already. Yeah, that'll be fun. I'm looking forward to Nurgle. In the league you run, you just lost a semi-final to a Movement 10 Agi-5 gutter runner who scored a hat trick. Nothing to be done. Yeah, you get games like that. When we was playing our, like, I had a Wood Elf team for a while, and we had a couple of Agi things, a couple of Agi plus Agi, I think, on that team. The team just went crazy. He was literally away for 5 minutes. What happened to the Delphs? Well, the Delphs spent the first few turns of the game punching skinks and got nowhere. And then the lizard men killed a bunch of elves. Well, killed one elf and injured a bunch more. And that's kind of the way it went. Yeah, and I hope the stream's not dropping frames for anyone. It looks okay at my end.
That ball's starting to look a little tatty.
Hopefully the stream will see an increase in quality soon. I'm gonna apply for the partnership thing so that I can stream in 1080 and people can
buzzkill.
Can then adjust the picture quality to whatever suits them. Whether or not I get it is another thing entirely. But seeing as I can apply multiple times, I will apply for it and hope for the best. So everyone keep your fingers crossed.
That one's got fists bigger than ham joints.
Oh, another one. Another one bites the dust. God, this is getting a bit out of hand, is it? Isn't it? Lizard killed one dead and one gets a... Oh, yeah, sorry. Yeah, two dead. Yeah, because one got minus strength as well, didn't he? Yeah, so two dead. Two dead and a bunch of injuries. The blow of might, indeed. The blow of might. It's mighty indeed.
I imagine that in their dreams, at least, they're winning this match.
We're down to six. Myself, it's time for the hero plays. You are not dead. No, you're not dead, Grumpy. You're just being forced to take early retirement. Yeah, I think it must be a bug. We just can't see the skills. Like, I don't think that these Saurus have no skills. I think they've actually all got Mighty Blow, and Block, and Claw or something. We just can't see. The guy's clearly hacking. it's the only explanation. How you doing, Corey? Good to see you, my man. good to see you. Strength is overrated. I can still play. You sound like the Black Knight. It's just a flesh wound. What do you mean it's just a flesh wound? I've cut your goddamn arm off. That's all right. I've had worse. Come back here. Come back here and I'll bite your willy off. I love that film. I love it. Just a flesh wound.
The bigger they are, the thicker they tend to be.
I've had worse. You wish Shores would start with Prehensile Tail? Gosh. That would just be so horrible to play against. They'd have to be way more expensive. But no, because then if they were more expensive, well then you could have them start with Prehensile Tail, make them more expensive, but then people would have to play with more skinks on the pitch. Now he's doing Saurus Fowls with no Bright. This game. Come on, ref. Seriously. You're gonna play Blood Bowl 2 for today just to stab me once? No, you can't. I'm not playing you on my democracy teams. Oh yeah, for anyone that doesn't know, yeah, the game is actually on sale this weekend. It's on it's half price on Steam. Yeah, I noticed that, and I was gonna mention it, but I forgot all about it. But yeah, sniping me when I'm playing on a democracy team sounds like a bit of a dick move, Nosedive. Come on. Don't be that guy. You're all line rat team. No, I don't really have any interest in playing in the, like in all line rat team. I have no. It's boring as hell. So no, Nosedive. I have no interest in playing any of your teams. I really don't.
Well done.
I was hoping he would have to burn a reroll trying to pick up the ball. He has actually already burned one reroll, which is good. If we can actually get... I don't know. What are we going to do here? Is there any actual... is there even any actual way we win this game? Probably not.
Violence, Jim. It's the only answer.
You want to see a Croxy foul? He may do it. I mean, he was perfectly happy. I mean, that guy boneheaded. I mean, that's some sweet, sweet elf bullshit, but at this point, why the hell not?
Nice. Very nice.
I might as well try and make the reroll. Ah, never mind. We had a chance for glory. Lunch is ready. See you later. See you later on, Lem. And thanks for stopping by. And yeah, hopefully I'll see you again, my man. You have a good one. Like, GIMP players, some GIMP players, it's not the worst thing in the world. I think it just depends on the GIMP. Like, you can live with an Agi 1 Black Orc. Or an... like... Strength 2 Black Orcs. Yeah, that'd be pretty rough.
Gone into the opponent's tackle zone. There, should be good.
Da, da, da.
This player, the attacker, smells weakness.
It's a shame that, like, this was our... I feel like this was our chance to maybe win this, because if we could have knocked the ball on the floor, it's not like we could have scored or anything, and he would have probably just crushed us again anyway. But then at least he would have had to go and pick the ball up again. As it stands, now we're... Now we're going to have no chance to punch the ball carrot without some exceptionally crazy dodges.
Ball is secure. Can the other team steal it away?
You once saw an armor value 3 Snotling. Jesus. Oh crap, is it my go? Sorry, I got distracted. Someone was talking to me. Right. What's the best way to go about this? I mean, that's just never going to happen. So... You, I'm going to dodge last. You stay there just to be annoying. You're going to...
That's quite a few of the opposition surrounding that player. They need to be very careful.
That's it. Force them back and then pound.
The player's fist is approximately the same size as his entire opponent. Twinkletoes there.
How much time? Dinner soon. I'm looking forward. I haven't had a proper Sunday dinner in forever. Yeah, this Dark Elf seems having a pretty rough time of it. I think tomorrow I'm going to put some serious time into this Dark Elf team, try and get like a good 4 or 5 games of them, and see if we can actually get through a couple of games without everyone dying and getting injured. That would definitely be good for us. So nice not to have to worry about studying for a while.
Not a wise place to end your turn on the border of the pitch. If the player gets pushed into the crowd, well, last time that happened, it took...
Edwin Holmes, thank you very much for the follow, man. Together. I really, really appreciate it. I'm glad you enjoyed the stream, and I hope you enjoyed your little goblin dance. Thank you. Much obliged, good sir. Much obliged. The human democracy team is, yeah, it's around about the 1500 mark. Nothing too crazy. They're getting up there, but around about 1500. Unfortunately, because we got, like, things wouldn't be so bad if these guys hadn't have got straight up injured and we had a couple of KOs to maybe... Because we could have, like, let him score, got a couple of KOs back, and maybe tried to score in one or two turns. But as it stands, that's a little bit on the awkward side. I do get to surf a skink, maybe. Oh, you already moved. Okay.
Any action this player makes risks a turnover.
Just one more step.
Oh, he's going to get into.
Well, at least the crowd got one. The crowd got a skink. The crowd finally got a skink. There we go, okay. Whoa. Yeah, I definitely want to. We're going to need to give these guys. We just need to give the Dark Elves an extended run. I mean, to be fair, that's actually, the very first game we played on the Dark Elves went really badly. Under normal circumstances, most people would probably have just restarted the team. But we've stuck it out because, you know, we don't ditch teams because things went bad before them. And this guy, like this guy scoring as quick as he could, I actually agree with that. If I was in his situation, I would have done exactly the same thing. Because even though he's giving us the ball back, the situation we are in, like he's got way more chance of just taking the ball off us and scoring again than we have of actually scoring. It's going to take some pretty ridiculous stuff for us to.
To be a hell of a kick.
Corey. No problem, Corey. Everybody needs a tip in their pocket. It's the new stream. Now with added pocket tip. You go there. You go here. Actually, you go there. We need to be able to pick the ball up from wherever. Let's do something a bit on the fruity side. Like, this is not a good plan, but it's a plan. And the plan is this. Ooh, free move into adjacent square. Does that help us? Maybe. Maybe a little bit. Probably not, though. Okay.
That there are all Skaven leagues played in great caverns underground. The teams are backed by the powerful greater clans. So you have Clan Skaya teams, Clan Eshin teams.
No! So not Ladouble Skull.
Must be after Bob. Jim, don't talk to me for the next few downs.
Oh, I didn't even. Why am I such a doofus? I've ruined the plan. I had a plan. Pocket tip, best tip. Yeah. I had a plan, I ruined it. The plan was to blitz with this witch elf and then just run down here and then throw the ball to her. But I don't know why I decided that was a bad idea. What am I going to do now? I have to stick a guy in there. Nah, that doesn't really help me. Two dice uphill for the win. No skulls.
He didn't see the opponents around.
Ah, no skulls. I needed no skulls.
I hoping he got everything done he wanted to, because it's the other team's
game. Never mind. The double skull on the skink block as well, that hurt. But this is my... I kind of messed up. I forgot to blitz before I did this block. The plan was to push the skink and then obviously hit it and then run away and then just pick up the ball and throw it.
They'll need to scoop up that ball and quickly.
Going for the ball, but can they pick it up?
He'll get an assist now. Wuss.
I wonder if anyone's put up the
Unity is strength.
Unity is indeed strength, is it? Okay. Maybe we could pull off some sweet, sweet elf bullshit here. But it's going to be some... It would have to be some spectacular bullshit. Actually,
I'm getting hungry.
Like, bullshit of the highest caliber. It's next Sunday the 13th. Okay. That's good to know.
The player's taking the ball.
No, damn you. Close. You suck, game. Why didn't you make him... Well, that's actually... What the hell? Skink's doing the moonwalk. Go on, do it. Please do it. Oh, game. Right. We have one chance and one chance only.
All this focus on the ball is against the spirit of the game.
Go on. Go on. Just go this way. No, game. Never mind. Right.
Scooping up the ball with the opponent so close. Impressive.
Just keeps going.
The ball goes long. It's going to catch it.
Oh, just throw the ball down this end. God damn you, game. Why? Why? Never mind. We were close. We were close. I really thought we had a chance there. If we could have thrown the ball down here, then we're in a situation where again he has to try and pick up the ball with skinks with no reroll.
So am I. Just one more step.
If he fails the pick up, go on, do it. Do the random Saurus dodge for no reason, please. If he fails the pick up, then we're in with a chance again. Like, we have a chance.
Not a wise place to end your turn on the border of the pitch.
But we really need him to fail the pickup. Please, game. Well, come on. Like, you've butchered our team, and we've lived with it. Like, we can live with you butchering our team. But, like, at least let us come out of this with a draw. You know, be nice to us. We've tried. We're trying. Like, we're working hard to try and make the world a better place for Dark Elves everywhere. So please, please let us get out of this with a draw. Surf the croc. Yeah, the good old two dice uphill croc surf.
Oh.
all the powers. We just honestly, I just need him to fail the pickup. Like if he fails the pickup and the ball goes off the pitch, we have a chance of being able to actually score. But if he doesn't fail the pickup, then we're screwed. Because the game hates me. Go on, fail the pass. Do it. Fail the pass.
Here comes the last chance pass.
See what I mean? Game is bullshit. Game is bullshit. Look at this nonsense. Look. Never mind. What can you do? Never mind. We tried. I feel like we, you know what, considering how bad of a spot we were in, we made this way more awkward for him than it should have been. Like, it should have been so easy for him to just score twice.
One of the teams got a play hidden up there.
Never mind.
Sleeves, then they need to action it before time runs out.
We tried. God damn, Lizard Man. Proxy foul. Yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. It wouldn't surprise me. Ah, Saurus foul. Okay. Why not?
Stomping on the player's neck with those studded boots that hard?
Oh, stunned. Okay. At least no one's dead. Can't reach him. Okay. I don't think we can one turn with this few players, but we will see. I'm almost certain we can't. And honestly, against Lizard Men, it's really hard to do the one turn anyway because of all the strength four. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I don't think we can.
It's a fresh start. Carnage can start all over again.
Honestly, there's kind of no way to do it. Oh yeah, well I was thinking that out loud when, like, you hear what I say like a bit after I see the chat, or like, I don't know something. I'm getting confused now, but you know what I mean. Like, I say it, and then you type it, and then you hear me say it. Is that Cravy? Cravy, I hope that's right. Cravy Crapula. Thank you very much for the follow, my man. I really, really do appreciate it. I'm glad you are enjoying the stream. And I hope you enjoyed your little goblin dance. Thank you. We definitely want to try and pick the ball up. We're gonna go for the vanity pass, because why would you not? If we can at least get a level up on a witch elf, that might help a little bit. And we're also going to punch some skinks to see if we can actually get some star player points. So that is the plan. Oh, never mind.
You know, this reminds me of the time you got bored and chained all the goblin technicians together to create a living mace.
Oh, yeah. Now that was a weapon of mass reconstruction.
This player likes to be well assisted in a fight.
Saurus catch, yeah. That would be pretty hilarious if you just ran a Saurus down here and the Saurus was like, sweet. But it kind of screws up my opportunity for a vanity pass. If he does it. God damn you. I mean, why would you even bother? Oh, come on. He's gonna turn 16 foul me on a blitz. Oh. Thank the Lord.
Here comes the other team.
That was pretty. Like, you know what? Like, everyone knows my feelings on fouls. Like, you know what it is. It is what it is. It's a part of Blood Bowl. But turn 16 foul on a blitz. That is pretty. Like, that you've got to be completely committed to being a dick to do that. you got to be like, you know what? I am fully committed to being as big a dick as possible. Oh, we finally KO'd one, turn 16. I mean, the crowd injured one. I think we KO'd two. I think we KO'd two skinks and the crowd eventually injured one. That was pretty funny. Like, don't get me wrong. I don't hate him for doing it. I really don't hate him for doing it. It's fine. But, like, if you're the guy who's like, you know what, I've just won 2-1 and I've killed two of his players and injured four more of them, but I've got a blitz on turn 16. The only correct thing for me to do here is to surround a player and foul him. then you, sir, are a special kind of Blood Bowl coach. Lot. And the dead runner. The dead runner gets the MVP. Game. Why do you hate me? Why do you hate my Dark Elf team, game? Why do you hate my Dark Elf team? Why would you give my dead runner the MVP? Oh, it was both runners. One runner died and the other one got minus. Hold up. So this is what, three dead people? Because one runner died, one runner got minus strength, and one lineman got minus armor. God damn it. Right, you're getting fired. And you're getting fired. Oh. This is what I get for, you know what it is? It's because the game knows that I have an assassin in the team. The game's like, you have an assassin in the team, you shouldn't be playing it. So I'm just going to kill all your players. Right. Let's see what we get on the Witch Elf. No doubles, unfortunately. So just general or Agi.
Big Jobo Hairyfoot comes back from the dead to talk about his.
Yeah, it's been a. We've had some iffy MVP decisions this today. I'm so sorry, Grumpy. I'm so sorry. For the giveaway, the first person's name who comes out is gonna be the person who gets to pick the skill, and then I will pick another name, and that will be the name of our new player. I'm not quite sure. I assume we're gonna buy it, and I think we're probably gonna buy another runner. No, I suppose at this point, well, we got 100k. How much a lineman? Ah, see, like, everything's just so expensive as well. Yeah, we need the lineman. We can't afford to be running around with AV7 when we haven't even got a full team of players. So we will go. Although, no, we'll probably get a blitzer for the money. New blitzer. We're going to get a new blitzer. Yeah, that's it. You are indeed all correct. We should get a new blitzer. Right. Let's see. Giveaway. Pick a winner. The richest T. Oh. What skill would you like on the Witch Elf? Is it two in a row? Are you the person that gave me leap on a blitzer, on my human blitzer?
I'm looking forward to the next match, Joe. Time for some Blood Bowl!
Oh, right, okay. You want it again? You want leap? You want leap on the witch elf? Oh, all the leap. See, the witch elf, there is the possibility that I may actually leap on. So that's not the worst thing in the world, right? As far as the blitzer goes, the new blitzer, that is going to be the Rattan. Rattan, you sir are our new blitzer. Would you like me to call him Rattan or the Rattan or anything else other than Rattan? You win. You do indeed win the beat on the team. You can always say no. You can always say I don't want to be on the team. You are indeed. Look, Bleck, I'm trying. The Rattan with head 6. Okay, well there you are. There's the Rattan and there's head 6. So, there we go. Yeah. I certainly don't want to force you into this relationship. There we go. Right, well. So we're down to 9 players.
I'm looking forward to these next,
but we have an extra blitzer. It's been rough. It's been rough. Our elf team are what? They won the first one and then lost 2-2-1s, which was a bit harsh. And both times they just got... Honestly, we won this one and just lost a bunch of guys. And then we lost this one because we had a bunch of guys injured. And then he got more guys injured. And then we're just struggling. For the person...